Hi again, basic modeling in 3ds Max, getting into the detail. That is the, I will call that a second lesson, the lesson two of what I'm trying to do here. I want to start with repeating some of what I did at the end of the last video, here in a lower motion, because we already got into the detail in the previous video, and I wanted to show you slower what I did. I won't explain everything because you should try it by yourself. Probably for you that will try to do it by your own, it won't be hard to repeat what I did here. It's good for all of you. The practice is always better than just talking. Well, I got silent because, as I said, it's better to try it by yourself than just talking. So here is my time for a joke of the day. A new student came to the class after telling the rest of the children his name. The teacher asked, "What does your father do?" Student: "Whatever mom says. Well, that could be funny for those of you who have kids. But leave it there. I'm running faster the next part because you've already seen it. I don't want to repeat it again as much because there is a lot to come up that is coming. Getting into the detail. I decided to get back because it. In the previous video, that part just stayed without comment, and actually it is good to see that building the geometry is a process which should take its steps. Adding more geometry, adding more edges where the, for example, in that area where there is a round part, and it so to get smooth and the curve, you should have more geometry. Here you could see I'm using that FFD modifier. It could be really helpful to get the basic direction of the model, especially for the seating pillows. Usually that helped me a lot. Again, nothing extraordinary here, just adding edges on the seat, on the pillow seat. So here I'm measuring the front of the height of the seat pillow. It's important to keep bit as possible the size of what you do comparison with what is the real object looks. Something that I want to explain here, no matter how difficult it is to do in English, is I'm putting here turbo smooth is just to see how the shape will be smoothed. As you see under, because there is not a close edge that is helping the shape, the volume to turn, it gets darker. So wherever you need, if you need more sharp edge or more sharper turning of the shape, you should put the edge closer to the angle where the shape is turning. I'm doing the same here. I want to have a bit sharper edge, so I'm putting the edge enough close to where the shape is turning. Time for another joke? No, I'm joking, there won't be jokes. But let's say that is the second part of this video. We'll see you, now you're seeing the familiar plane that I was using in the previous video, which will help me now to find the angle of the back. You always can use the scheme as a background, but I wouldn't advise that, because usually those schemes are not so much representing the real feeling of the sofa. So what I mean is that sometimes you can do it perfectly as the scheme look like, the plans of the furniture looks like, but then to not have the character of the model, to not have the character of that furniture. So it's good to keep that in mind, to have it, sometimes to use it, but probably better not directly, but having it aside, it will help you for sure, but not putting it as a background. As you see, what I do is I'm putting only references, the photos of the real furniture piece. So here you see I'm starting modeling the back of the seat, again with using this FFD modifier on a polygon level, just selecting some polygons and putting on them FFD. You see here that's from the plane, the black, so the plane. But yeah, what you see here is I'm trying to make the geometry, the mesh of the back available or put in such an order, so it would help me to get to the shape I want to. I'm talking a lot about feelings, maybe because I'm a woman, I don't know, but the truth is that sometimes you can get it like really like to copy it, but really to not have the character of the and the feeling of it, or the softness of the sofa, especially that in that example that I'm giving you, it's actually nothing extraordinary as a design, but the feeling of the softness is there. So no matter that is kind of a simple design, still you should have this feeling of softness, you know, of the. So you see here I'm using soft selection, again something that it's a good and fast, gives a good and fast result. So here is a one detail where you could show that you pay attention, and I'm attaching the two parts of that, and I'm using on the polygon level soft selection to try to get that result of that upper part that is pushing a bit the armrest. It's a small detail, but it helps to get to give life to the 3D model. These small details sometimes we might not pay attention to them, but these small details are making the 3D model more alive. So as you see, sometimes I'm selecting an edge, and at once it's disappear. The shortcut for that is control backspace, or if you just do backspace, the vertex stays there, just the edge is gone. It's something that you can try by yourself. So set flow connect, these are one of the instruments that I'm using a lot, and as you see, cut. I'm trying to get this nice look of the mesh. So I speed it up from now on the video. I'm speeding up because it will take forever, and as you see, I'm kind of doing the same thing over and over. I'm moving edges, moving on vertex level, using the constraint on edge. It's good at, you know, when you are certain how your where the shape is going, to use that constraint on edge. It helps to keep the basic shape that you have already design model, because it's kind of, you can easily destroy that level of the mesh, of the shape. Once you found the right shape, it's good to keep it as much as you could, while continuing and adding geometry. That's really important to not lose it. Yeah, here the same thing. I'm adding edges, especially where they're in that place where the two parts are pushing each other, and because of the curve of the back, it's needed more geometry. To get better result after smoothing. I hope it won't be boring for those of you who are still there. But yeah, here is the result till now. I'm using actually V-Ray renderer. They're my favorite. Not men, because I'm Bulgarian and Bulgarian is too bad. The materials were just simple materials without any difficulties, you know. Simple material just to see how the shape that I'm building, how does it look on the render. Actually, I like to have some to render it in between modeling. I know that this is the way I'm doing it. I prefer to have a material close to the one that will be like that will be the final material, because when you order it, when you render it in material, you see what what is seen on the render or what is not seen. Sometimes things that you are so convinced that they will be seen, they are not visible at all. Sometimes the way it's smooth, and because of the quality of the material, and for example if it's a textile, if it's a velvet or other kind of a textile, it has a different quality inside of the material. So the light goes, you know, where the light is touching the material, you know, it gets a different result to comparison with what the textile is. So long story short, it's good to render it in between modeling, because this is the one good way to see what you're modeling, how it appear on the render. Well, there is a lot of way this sofa to go till the end. At the end of this video, I will show you a clay render of the final result. For a pity, I didn't record it exactly the part. Maybe some of you that will be interested of the way I'm doing the faults. Although that sofa especially, there is not a lot of faults, but I mean folding, you know, in the front of the cushions, there are some, but not a lot. But still, I did some to give that sofa character, or just to make it more alive. So in the end, I will show you that. If you have questions or whatever, if something that you are interested of what I did and you didn't understand how I did it, just give me a note and I will try to explain better. So I'm about to finish that video with the renders that I promised you to show you, with the final result of the modeling of this sofa. I told you that this is a basic modeling, meaning that this, of course, the end of this video is getting harder for someone that is just starting. But actually, if some of you have studied the arts or modeling with physical material, or drawing, you'll see that it's not much different of if you do it in the physical world. Of course, you need to know the instruments, and in that case here especially, I may do another special video for how I navigate the perspective, so to get the same angle of the camera as the photos that I have, because it's not so easy actually. And I know there are some automatic ways to do this, but actually I never tried them, so I could show you how to do that manually with the instruments of the 3ds Max. Yeah, that's all from me, guys. Hope you enjoy it. Hopefully I'll have some comments from you, or just let me know if you like it or didn't like it or whatever. I'm enjoying doing it, so thank you for all of you that stayed till and watched that video till the end. Hope to hear from me soon or not. Have a nice day. Bye.